Assalamu alaikum. The question has been raised that is the Shahada, the phrase that Muslims recite during their daily prayers as well as during the Azan, does it have Quranic basis? Is it based on the Quran and is it a valid practice to recite this phrase? The Shahada is a very common phrase that Muslims recite as part of their faith. It is a canonical phrase as it occurs in the Azan, the call to prayer, as well as during the Salah itself. This phrase is part, it is based on the Quran itself. The words of the Shahada in a short form are La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, which means there is no God except Allah and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. These two components of the Shahada, La ilaha illallah and Muhammadur Rasulullah, they are Quranic words. They occur exactly verbatim in this form in the Quran. In numerous verses we read La ilaha illallah in the Quran. In Surah Al-Fatah, which is chapter number 48, verse number 29, we read Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. So these are Quranic words. And recitation of the Quran is not sinful, as it is alleged by some people that if you recite La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, you are committing a sinful act. Within certain circles, this is being promoted. However, this is wrong, because the words are based on the Quran itself, and reciting Quranic words is not sinful, it is not shirk, as is suggested by these people. Secondly, the people who oppose the Shahada, they say that you are not supposed to be a witness over the messenger, peace be upon him. You are not supposed to bear testimony on him. This view of theirs is also blatantly against the Quran. When we read the Quran, we find proof, we find evidence for believers to bear testimony, to bear witness over the messenger. For example, in Surah Ali Imran, chapter number 3, and verse number 86, we read, كَيْفَ يَحْدِي اللَّهُ قَوْمًا كَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِيمَانِهِمْ وَشَهِدُوا أَنَّ الرَّسُولَ حَقٌّ وَجَاءَهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Meaning, how can Allah guide a people who have rejected after they had believed and they bore witness that the messenger was true? This is the important phrase in this verse. وَشَهِدُوا أَنَّ الرَّسُولَ حَقٌّ. After people had believed, وَشَهِدُوا أَنَّ رَسُولٌ حَقٌّ, they bore witness that the messenger was true. So in this verse, we come to know that it is part of being guided to bear witness on the messenger. So in this verse, it is a clear proof that to bear witness on the messenger is a part of a guided act. A person who is guided by Allah, he has to make this declaration. Secondly, we find in Surah Ar-Ra'd, chapter number 13, verse number 43, it says, وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَسْتَ مُرْسَلًا. The unbelievers say that you are not a messenger, referring to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The disbelievers, they say that you are not a messenger. قُلْ كَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدٌ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ وَمَنْ عِنْدَهُ إِلْمُ الْكِتَابِ. Say, sufficient as a witness between you and me is Allah and he who has knowledge of the book. The verse clearly says, he who has knowledge of the book, he is a witness over the messenger. So it is wrong to say that you cannot be a witness over the messenger. You can be a witness, because those who have knowledge of the book, the Quran says they are witnesses over the messenger. How can you say that you cannot be a witness over the messenger? This is totally wrong. It is a view which is against the Quran. The Quran says that those who have knowledge of the book, they are witnesses. The Quran says that وَشَهِدُوا أَنَّ رَسُولَ حَقٌّ, that people who are on guidance, they bear witness that the messenger is true. The Quran has the words La ilaha illallah. The Quran has the words Muhammadur Rasulullah. Therefore, when we recite these words in our prayer, during our salah, we are not doing something against the Quran. In fact, we are following the Quran when we are doing that. Exactly. So we must take guidance from the Quran, and any belief that is promoted to us, we should check and verify whether the verses of the Quran justify that belief or not. As far as the Shahada is concerned, it is a belief which is justified by the Quranic verses.